we're going to talk about whether you should invest in a traditional 401k or a Roth 401k. I currently work with a Chinese immigrant couple in their early 30s, both with PhDs in high-paying jobs. Their combined income exceeds $300,000 a year, putting them in the 24% federal tax bracket. This means that if they put $10,000 into a traditional 401k, they would receive a $2,400 federal tax deduction. Despite their high income, I recommended that they contribute it into a Roth 401k instead. And in this video, I'll explain why their age, career potential, and their state of residency influence the recommendation. Before we get started, I have been a financial advisor and certified financial planner for over a decade, but I'm not your financial advisor. So this video is for educational purposes only and not meant to be financial advice. They want to be financially independent by age 50, which is possible given their frugal lifestyle, high savings rate, and a well-thought-out investment plan, and the biggest factor of all, the fact that they are starting to invest so young. Paying fewer taxes throughout their life, both while working and in retirement, could help them retire even earlier. So deciding between a traditional and Roth 401k is important. Here are three reasons why I suggest that they pay $11,000 more in taxes each year in order to put money into a Roth 401k. Number one, they're young and willing to take investment risk. They are maximizing their 401ks and backdoor Roth IRAs, saving $60,000 annually, plus an additional $20,000 to $30,000 in a taxable account with a global stock index portfolio. With two more decades of compound growth, they could accumulate $4 to $6 million by age 50. Having this money tax-free is a smart way to prepay taxes that they typically owe in retirement. If all of their 401k savings were in a traditional 401k, they would face taxes on every distribution and required minimum distributions at age 73. Number two, they're just starting their careers in STEM and finance and are likely going to be in a higher tax bracket in the future. Both of them have income growth potential that likely would outpace inflation, and currently they are in the 24% federal tax bracket, and they might soon move into the 32% or higher tax bracket as their income exceeds $400,000 as a household. So they're likely in one of the lowest tax brackets of their working career now. Number three, they live in a state with no income tax, like Florida, Texas, or Washington, resulting in a relatively low marginal tax bracket of 24%. If they later retire in a high income tax state like California, they could end up paying significantly more in taxes. And finally, I put the numbers into a comprehensive planning tool and confirmed that choosing the Roth over the traditional 401k gave them a better retirement. You can see that either choices are good and will contribute to a successful early retirement, as their chance of having enough money for the rest of their lives is in the high 80s percentile. Putting money into a Roth 401k does give a slight edge and a higher ending net worth. And now moving beyond the numbers, Roth retirement accounts offer psychological benefits over a traditional pre-tax retirement account that are hard to quantify. First, prepaying your taxes now is often easier when you're young and still working and your taxes are automatically withheld. It is harder to handle tax payments in retirement when you have to make quarterly payments out of pocket and you feel the pain of paying the taxes a lot more directly. Many people who choose a traditional 401k might think, hey, I've contributed $23,000 to my traditional 401k, so I'm done and Dave Ramsey is happy. But then they forget to invest the additional tax refund. Choosing a Roth 401k means paying about $11,000 more in taxes each year for this particular client, but the account grows tax-free and they end up with a better retirement because they can spend 100% of their Roth 401k distributions. Financial planning, whether through boring index funds for the long term or gambling in individual stocks for a quick gain, is about gaining more freedom and choices. A Roth 401k provides the flexibility to move to any other state without worrying about high taxes in retirement. For now, maximizing their 401k makes sense, but this strategy isn't set in stone. As their career progresses and they receive pay raises, it might make sense to switch. Having all of their retirement savings in Roth accounts might not always be ideal too, especially since they plan to retire early and have the opportunity to convert their traditional 401k money into a Roth IRA money at a lower tax rate. I hope you enjoyed this case study and learned that not every single conventional wisdom applies when you look at specific cases. Thanks for watching, and I wish you the best.